Yeah, I'm with the Fire Frank November 6th campaign, and I'm here because Frank Ginta is a congressman who's running for re-election, who is currently under federal investigation for alleged campaign finance fraud, and who literally voted to take food away from hungry children, kick hundreds of thousands of kids off school lunch, to give millionaires a $300,000 tax break. Anyone who believes in such a reverse morality like that, just, you know, rob from the poor and give to the rich. Anyone who is in office and who is seeking office doesn't need to be in office and needs to be voted out of office. So, myself and other folks here, we got about 50. We're all just getting the word out about Ginta when he's coming here to have his big fundraiser at this ball game, and let the city of Manchester know we don't appreciate him too much.
How are you trying to get the word out about Frank?
So right now we've got a really great social media campaign. Fire Frank November 6th. It's on Facebook and on Twitter. And we're using memes to circulate with Ginta's face on them, associated with popular internet memes, to really just illustrate the ridiculousness of how Ginta stands on certain issues, right? Like, here's an example. Like the Dos Equis guy, the most interesting man in the world.
Yes.
Instead of his face, it's Ginta's face, and he's going like this, and he's wearing a suit. And it says, you know, I don't always deliver meals on wheels, but when I do, it's right after I cut Meals on Wheels. He did a photo op giving Meals on Wheels to a senior the day he voted for the Ryan budget, which defunds Meals on Wheels to increase the Pentagon budget.
Well, do you think that Frank is a hypocrite? They had a federally funded bridge put in just last year that was funded by Obama's stimulus funds, which he technically is against, right. Is voting against. But he was there at the ribbon cutting, right, Claiming credit for it. Is his hypocrisy,
you know,
what you want to highlight?
They always talk about how much they hate big government spending, except when it creates jobs in their district, you know, except when it helps veterans, you know, get the food and care that they need to get by every day. You know, they hate government spending, except the kind that funds the military and, you know, funds the roads and funds the courts, funds society and things.
Except if it's the Veterans Administration.
Exactly, and then you vote to defund it.
When the previous Republican congressman, they attacked the VA here. I'm a veteran.
Yeah.
They cut the funding so badly because it was part of, they wanted to privatize the veterans hospital system, put everybody in HMOs. Then we got, but Carol Shea Porter was a Democrat. Her father had been a veteran. Mm-hmm. They hired 200 people and they brought it back from the debt.
Wow.
Debt, I know, because I use the VA.
Okay.
That's my healthcare provider.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, and speaking of healthcare, you know, for the 33rd time, Frank Ginta voted to repeal Obamacare right after the Supreme Court upheld it as constitutional. And, you know, and I think it's really interesting that, you know, you would vote to, you know, I'm not sure what his alternative is. I mean, I heard the Republican alternative to Obamacare is to repeal Obamacare and then replace it with 30 million uninsured Americans. You know, and I think that's Ginta's plan. I think the Ginta plan, and you can look for this later, we'll keep you in the loop about it. But we're actually planning a really fun stunt. We're going to build a coffin and have people in black robes walk down Elm Street and deliver it to his campaign office. And when you open up the coffin, it's going to say, Ginta's alternative to Obamacare. You know, that's what the Republicans do. They want you to die.
What